Effective leadership through enforcement of positive values, the destination of a nation defined. Just like a towing van, a leader can be effective if others around are influenced to grow. Effective leadership is the ability to help people grow in their own abilities while communicating the vision of an organization or society and enforcing right values. It is our collective responsibilities as citizens to ensure that everyone is tilted towards common positive values. This would consequently lead to breeding good governance system, because those who get elected into office are from the part of the citizenry of a nation. Just like a cup of water fetched from a well or a stream is as clean or as dirty as the overall content of the entire well or stream. You may want to ask, what values could we ensure that effective leadership enforces? This could be summarized as thus: brotherhood, love other tribe or ethnicity or race. They say variety is the spice of life. Education, learning and development should be evolving and in tandem with progressive global views and highly beneficial to the younger generations especially. Empathy and tolerance, respect persons of diverse view, be they religious or political. Differences should be a complementary strength and not discord enablers. Rule of law or regulations. Respect order and institutions should supersede individual interests. Honor and integrity. Being truthful and accountable, both as individuals or as an institution. Duty towards country or nation. Being conscious about national service and willingness to render assistance when necessary, especially in turbulent times. Intentional economic growth and social development. Can you imagine having a rich man from a poor country? In conclusion, protecting and enforcing positive values is more important than conserving gold, oil, limestone, or any other national resource. Our food for thought. Keep your thoughts positive because your thoughts become your word. Keep your word positive because your word become your behavior. Keep your behavior positive because your behavior becomes your habit. Keep your habit positive because your habit becomes your values. Keep your values positive because your values becomes your destiny. That's from Mahatma Gandhi, an Indian nationalist.
Well, that's well said. I completely agree with what you're saying, because I've always said that, I think I've said it during the last time I appeared on this program, that we all complain about government is bad, this is bad. I think by now, over the years, we know. So should our complaint still be that government is bad? Shouldn't we rather be focusing on what we can do to make sure that we get things better, not just for ourselves, but for the entire area? Now, you made mention of, the impact, and you talked about society and, making the society grow and everything. And this is what I'll say. Now, the federal government is working on the second Niger Bridge. I heard a report sometime last week that says that while the second Niger Bridge is being done, I think it was one correspondent, Adeni Ikunu, a renowned journalist that went there to the east, and said, while the second Niger Bridge is being done, work is ongoing, moving on well. The adjoining roads are terrible. Now, the adjoining roads, I'm not sure, but most likely might be state roads. If we really love our country, while the federal government is working on the second Niger Bridge, shouldn't we as a state be working on the adjoining roads, such that when the second Niger Bridge is done, the people will see the full value and benefits of the second Niger Bridge? You see, our values are wrong. I always tell people that, listen, if we say today that President Buhari is terrible, this is bad, blah, 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 we see all our politicians are nasty. You remember that we always say that these politicians are the same people that have been leading us since the 80s, since the 70s. But the question is, yes, since the 60s, we've been saying there's corruption in Nigeria. However, what happened then that the consumption rate was way lower than what we have now? They stole, that's all we all say, so that nobody will come and arrest me. I'm not the one saying it. But we all agree that there was corruption back in the day, and there was pilfering. Money was leaving our coffers. Nigeria was losing money. People were traveling abroad, investing, and blah, blah, blah. Yes. But how come the magnitude of corruption back then has increased like 10 times more right now. One of the answers, I believe, to that is the fact that our values have completely depleted.
Deteriorated, yeah.
You know, from the 80s to now. So while you still then being conscious of, if these people see me, they will not honor me. Right now, you consume knowing that when I go to the people, they know I've brought them money. So you are encouraged to steal more.
Because our values, you need to get this right.
We need to get comfort. I'm sure comfort being a lawyer. Let's hear what she's saying.
I think, you know, several times on this program, we've spoken about, you know, how bad Nigeria is, especially from the point of the citizens and the fact that we've lost the lessons that most of us grew up with, the values, the community that most of us grew up with. I mean, I think for me, the most irresponsible statement that I hear from parents is, these children, they are of this generation. And you wonder, what do you mean, these children? You gave birth to them, they came in as blank slates, and you are the one training them, and you are blaming them for their bad behavior. Mm. So even we, I don't know whether it is the same mental health issue that has gotten to that sector too, where we are letting our children run riot, because what we are instilling in them is what is going to continue on in their lives. Is what is going to now become the basis of the foundation of their own society. Mm. I mean, I love this topic, you know, bringing back those things that we grew up with, the sense of community, sense of duty, yeah. You know, sense of brotherhood and all that. But the truth about it is that it has been completely dissipated, and we are not even helping, because the next generation that we're bringing up, we're not teaching them. We're blaming them instead and saying that, and these children, that's how they are. Mm. What do you mean that's how they are? We must take responsibility at a certain point, and it's not too late.
That's
but the
it.
Problem is who will bail the cat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm going to just very quickly cite an example of a certain housemate, male reality show housemate, whose mother is like a prayer warrior, taught him in the way of the Lord, and still on social media they showed her really praying and preaching to him, giving him Bible, but he still released his nudes by mistake. So she has done her part, leading, bringing up her child through like enforcement of positive values. She has done her part.
She's done her part.
Suicidal values.
Exactly. She's done her part, but how many other parents did their part, which made it interesting?
Sabotaged.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. So,
she has done her part, and the child still chooses to do his own part. Like, what are we saying?
No, but what you're saying is at the end of the day, one tree doesn't make a forest. So the mother has done her part. But how many mothers did their part? For example, Tiwa Savage's new pictures were released. I've seen videos, but I've never opened it. Why should I be so excited to go and watch? But the fact that I was trained to honor people's nude whatever doesn't mean every other person wasn't. Imagine a lot of people didn't even watch or comment. No other person will release such a thing. But anyway,
when the summon bonum of the matter, Dolapo, your point is well noted, that the parents can do their part, but the generations, will they continue? This is the summon bonum of the matter. The summon bonum is that our value as a society is the summation of our individual values. So the more you have, it's just like in the world of finance. I want to go to the world of finance now. When you are taking a probabilistic outcome of a random event, let's say in the stock market or the forex market or in the equity, and then some of them are going to be winners, some of them are going to be losers. Yeah. What makes you a profitable trader is that the winners are more than the losers.
That's
the
same
when you have good values, the values are more.
Mm-hmm.
The poor values or wrong values are there. But the moment the values are positive and are more, it will somehow
neutralize. That's true.
Well said. Yeah.
That's so let's try our best to make Nigeria work.
Just to play the devil's advocate, what part do you think we are leading to in this country? Is it more of the
I think it shows off.
The destination of the country is enshrining the values. So our destiny is in our hand. We should stop crying. I just saw a video. I'm not going to mention the political party, but they know themselves. In fact, I'm sure others will respond too. Now, this political party, they were distributing money. See the way the guy was just doing, the man was doing it as though he was giving something that their life depends. And women were collecting this money. Anambra election.
Every
everybody, but I saw women more. I know
because
the men, I'm not exonerating the men.
Yeah. They go to where women are the ones in the marketplaces. These people.
Well, it's not a gender thing. No, it's just saying that everybody was.
I'm not saying gender. I'm
it's
saying
not, it's just
point the mindset. Point the mindset. I saw some women collecting the money. Now these women will still come back and complain and say this, that, that, that.
Those poor people, both the men and the women, will
come
back and.
Sure. Definitely, I'm not saying that is the women. I'm just saying what I saw.
I see a gender fight here. Let's bring you.
Coming from, because that's what he's talking about. That's I like where Felix is coming from, because that's where he's emphasizing how the positive values were in society. In those days, even if a woman was poor, you could see, you would actually admire her, that the fact that she was in a certain economic situation didn't mean that she would sell her soul for it. But what he's saying is that now, even women who are supposed to be in court, the custodians, the ones who are holding them, children technically are the ones now on the front line of doing things that do not instill positive values.
Yeah,
thanks a lot for that.
Good point.
Well, thank you very much, everyone. Thank you. So the rapport wraps up the conversation after the break.